So last topic in this chapter, work power energy is power. Okay. So how can you define power? The rate of doing work. The rate of doing work. Okay. Is called power. That's it. So it means the power is nothing but work done in an unit time. This is called as power. Okay. Or how you can define a person is able to do how much work in a particular time. That is called as power. Okay. So some people can do more work in less time. Then we can say that the power of that person is greater. That's it, Nama. So consider if two people are doing same work. Okay, iddaru koolilanu teesukundam. They are unloading a lorry of rice packets. Rice packets lorry ni unload chestunnam anukundam. So one coolie is able to unload it in for example 50 packets are there. One coolie is able to unload in 10 minutes. One coolie is able to unload in 20 minutes. Work done by both of them is same, Nama. Work done is unloading 50 packets of rice. That is same. But what about time taken? For one person, time taken is lesser. For another person, time taken is greater. So who has more power? Power evariki ekkuvaga unnattu. The person who has done in less time. Clear? Because here, time is present in denominator, no? Time is present in denominator. If denominator is very, very, very small, then automatically power will be very, very, very big. That's all. For example, if you see, let us take P1 is equals to 100 joules of work he is doing in 1 second. Okay. And another person, let us consider, same 100 joules of work he is doing in 2 seconds. Work done is same. Here also 100 joules of work, here also 100 joules of work. But here time taken is 1 second, but here time taken is 2 seconds. So which person has more power? This person has more power. Clear? So here power will be how much? 100 watts. Joule per 1 second is called as watts. Clear now? Then what is the power in this condition? Power is only 50 watts of power. So that is the definition of work done. Able to understand? So if a person is able to do same amount of work in less time, then we say the power of the person is greater, or power of that particular machinery is greater. Are you able to understand? That is called as power. Okay, now see. So how can I define power, ma? So power is equals to total work done, divided by total time. Okay, ma? This power we call it as average power. What is this power, ma? Average power. Average power means what? Total amount of work done in total amount of time. Clear? So that power we can call it as PAV. PAV means average power done by the machinery or the person or anything. Clear? Similarly, power is equals to work done can be written as a force into displacement divided by time taken also I can write. Clear, Nama? So force into displacement divided by time. Okay? So power can also be written as force into displacement by time can be written as velocity. No? Work done I am writing F into S. F into S by time. S by T, velocity. Are you able to understand? No? So P average I can also call it as force into average velocity. This is another definition I can write. Clear now? So for the whole motion, if you take average velocity, then power will be average. Average power is equals to force into average velocity. Okay. Or if you take force into instantaneous velocity, velocity at a particular instant, then power is also instantaneous power. Are you able to understand? So force into instant average velocity will give average power. So force into instantaneous velocity will give instantaneous power. That's it. So these are some of the equations of power which you should remember for average power as well as instantaneous power. Are you able to understand, ma? And in some conditions you will get instantaneous power is 2 times of average power. Okay, ma? So when velocity of the body increases, I can say instantaneous power is a double to that of average power. Let us do one small question, ma, so that we can understand. Clear? Then, ma, body of mass 2 kg, we are applying a force of 10 newton. And this body should move by how much distance, ma? By 10 meters. Okay? And coefficient of friction is 0. So there is no friction. So I want to calculate average power and instantaneous power. So to calculate power, first I require work done, no ma? Work done. Total amount of work done is how much? Okay ma? So total work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Clear now? Force applied is how much? 10. Displacement is how much? 10. Force and displacement, they are in the same direction, no? Cos 0. So 100 joules of work is done. Clear now? So on an average, how much work is done? 100 joules of work is done. Okay. But this work is done in how much time? That time I don't know. So first of all, I am supposed to calculate time taken for this body to travel 10 minutes. Okay. So let us see how I can calculate time taken, ma. See, ma. So on 2 kg body, if I apply a force of 10 Newton, then what is the acceleration produced? A is equals to F by M, no ma. Force is 10 Newton. Mass of the body is 2 kg. So 5 meters per second square is the acceleration. This is the acceleration produced in this body, no? So with this acceleration, I can calculate time taken to travel 10 meters. No? How can I calculate? I can use S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Clear, no? Clear, no? So therefore, S value, displacement is 10, initial velocity is 0 plus half, acceleration is 5, time taken, I don't know. So time taken is t square. So 5 1s are 5 2s are. So t square is equal to 4, so t is equal to 2 seconds. Okay. So in how much time the body will travel 10 meters, it will take a time of 2 seconds. That I have calculated now. Now I can calculate average power now. What is average power? Total work done divided by total time. That is called as average power. Already we have discussed total work done by total time is called average power. So calculate. So first one, P average. Total work done, 100 joules. Total time, 2 seconds. So 50 watts of power. So that is the average power delivered by this force. So average power we have calculated number 50 watts. Now we will calculate instantaneous power. So what is the formula of instantaneous power? So F into V instantaneous. This is the equation of instantaneous power. So instantaneous power means when it has traveled a distance of 10 meters. There I want to calculate instantaneous power. Not at the starting position. I want to calculate instantaneous power after it has traveled 10 meters. Okay. So to calculate instantaneous power, I need instantaneous velocity. How can I calculate instantaneous velocity? Instantaneous velocity is nothing but final velocity only, no ma? How can I calculate final velocity? V is equals to u plus at. V is equals to u plus at. V, initial velocity is 0, acceleration is 5, time taken is 2 seconds. So V is equals to 10 meters per second. So I calculated instantaneous velocity, no? Clear, no? It means body, after covering a distance of 10 meters, how much will be its velocity? 10 meters per second. Clear, no? So therefore calculate P instantaneous. What is the formula of P instantaneous, ma? Force into V instantaneous. Force is how much? 10. Instantaneous velocity is how much? 10. 10 into 10? 100 watts. Clear, ma? So therefore, see, my average power is 50 watts, but instantaneous power is 100 watts. It is exactly double, no? So that's what I said, you know. Clear, no? So therefore, what is the conclusion I can write? P instantaneous is a double to that of P average in this condition when bodies are accelerating. Clear, no? When bodies are accelerating, this condition will be satisfied. Force should be constant, acceleration also should be constant, then this condition will be always satisfied. Okay. If you remember this one, without any calculation also you can say. If average power is 50, instantaneous power should be 100 because it will be double. But in which condition? Force should be constant. If force is constant, acceleration also will be constant. Then in that condition, this is satisfied. Clear now? So what is the note point I have to write? Note point is that. So if force is a constant, then instantaneous power is equals to 2 times of average power. That's very important relation. What's that? Average power ki inkoka equation edi cheppandi. Total work done by total time is one equation. Another equation also we have written. What is that? So average power is equals to force into average velocity also we have written. Now let us check whether we get the same answer by using this relation also or not. ఈ రిలేషన్ యూజ్ చేసినా మళ్ళీ అదే ఆన్సర్ వస్తుందో లేదో చూద్దాం. సో ప్రీవియస్లీ వీ గట్ యావరేజ్ పవర్ ఈజ్ 50 వాట్స్. నౌ లెట్ అస్ టేక్ ఇన్ దిస్ కండిషన్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ 50 వాట్స్ ఆర్ నాట్. ఓకేనా? సిమ ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ డెఫినెట్లీ హౌ మచ్ ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ సేమ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కాన్స్టెంట్ నో ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ 10 న్యూటన్. బట్ హౌ కెన్ ఐ క్యాల్కులేట్ యావరేజ్ వెలాసిటీ? యావరేజ్ వెలాసిటీ ఇనీషియల్ వెలాసిటీ ప్లస్ ఫైనల్ వెలాసిటీ డివైడెడ్ బై 2. బికాస్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ ఈస్ అ కాన్స్టెంట్ నో ఐ కెన్ రైట్ లైక్ దిస్. So the average of both velocities, initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Initial velocity is 0, final velocity is 10 divided by 2, how much? 5 meters per second. So this is the average velocity with which body has covered this 10 meters. Okay. So therefore, average power, how can I calculate ma? So force into average velocity. Force is how much? 10 newton. Average velocity is 5, so 10 5 is there. 50 watts. So by using this relation also I got the answer. Okay. So you can use any relation, no problem. Always you will get the same answer. That's it. So see this question. What is the power of an engine which can lift 600 kg of water per minute from a mine 20 meters deep? But how it is lifting water? It is lifting water in two different methods. That is, after lifting to the ground, water again has a velocity of 5 meters per second. That is, it is lifting water and it is releasing water on the ground with how much velocity? With the velocity of 5 meters per second. But in second condition, it is just lifting the water and it is not giving water any velocity. That is, after lifting, water doesn't have any velocity. Artham avutundi kada? So let us try to understand this by an example. See ma'am. So this is considered some borewell and this is a pipe. Okay. So we are fitting a, what you call, engine to this pipe ma'am. Then in the first condition, it is lifting by how much of height? Water is lifted by a height of 20 meters. Clear now? And after lifting, water is thrown with how much velocity? It is thrown with a velocity of 5 meters per second in the first condition. But in the second condition, it is thrown with zero velocity. It means just water is lifted, but water is not given any velocity. Are you able to understand? So in these two conditions, I am supposed to calculate what is the power of this engine. So let us see the first condition. So power, work done by time, no? Power is work done by time. And here he did not mention specifically about average power or instantaneous power. So here average power, instantaneous power, both are same. Are you able to understand, ma? Okay. So power is equals to total work done divided by total time. Okay. So first of all, how much work is done, ma? First, to lift this water from here to here, it should do work against the gravitational force, no? Engine should do work against the gravitational force, and that is nothing but potential energy mgh. That's all, no? First I should raise the potential energy of the water, no? So this reference I will take it as zero potential energy reference. So from this reference, water is taken to a height of 20 meters. Height is 20 meters. So there is a rise of potential energy, no? So work is done to raise the potential energy mgh. Okay. And water, after lifting up to here, then I am giving some velocity also. No? Velocity means again which energy? So mgh is the amount of work done to raise water, to raise its potential energy. Half mv square is the work done to give kinetic energy to water, and time taken is per minute number 60 seconds. So do this calculation and see what is the power of the engine. Okay, in the first case. So here I have 60, no? So 60, 60 I can cancel. Okay. So therefore 10 is left, 200, 2000. 2000 plus, and here also 10 is present. So 250 divided by 2, 125. That's all, no? So therefore 2125 watts. That is my answer. So 2125 watts. Clear? Now going to the second question. What is the second question? Water is lifted with 0 meters per second velocity. Okay, ma? Now in this condition, how can you answer? 0 meters per second velocity. Water is lifted definitely, but water is not given any velocity. Just it is lifted up to here and water is given 0 velocity. Then in this condition, how can I calculate power? Power of the engine. Chappandi. So power is equals to just mgh divided by time taken. That's all, no? Here there is no concept of half mv square, no? Half mv square will not be there because Work is done only to lift water, only to give potential energy to the water. Okay. So therefore, power is equals to how much already we have calculated, Nama? 600 into G value is 10 multiplied by 20 divided by time taken is 60. So 60, 60 cancel. So 2000 watts. That is our answer. Understood, Nama? Difference between first question and second question. Here two works are done. Work is done to give potential energy also. Work is done to give kinetic energy also. But in the second case, work is done only to give potential energy to the water. That's it. Fine. That is the question, ma. So in a hydroelectric plant, 7.2 into 10 power 4 kg of water falls per hour from a height of 100 meters, and half of the gravitational potential energy is converted into electrical energy. GPE means gravitational potential energy. So how much power is generated? That is the question. So this is a question based on hydroelectric plant. Clear? See, in a hydroelectric plant, dams will be there, no? In a hydroelectric plant, there will be a dam which stores water. Okay? And at the bottom of the dam, you will have a small passage for water. So this water comes down and it falls on a turbine. Clear, no? A turbine will be there. Water falls on the turbine. So this turbine starts rotation, and that rotational energy is converted into electrical energy with the help of electromagnets. That is what is happening. Clear, no? So here what is happening, so water is falling from a height of 100 meters, ma. So that is the distance between water and the turbine is how much? 100 meters. It means the turbine is present somewhere here. Okay, ma? So this height is 100 meters. Okay. Now half of this energy, so if it is falling from a particular height, water initially it has potential energy, no, ma? When you take this reference as zero potential energy reference, water is present at a height of 100 meters initially. It means this total potential energy of the water, it converts into kinetic energy. Water will gain velocity, no? So it converts into kinetic energy when it hits the turbine. Okay? And out of that total energy, only half of the energy is converted into electrical energy. It means remaining energy is wasted as heat energy. So efficiency is only 50%. Then how much power is generated? That is the question. Clear, no? So first of all, power is equals to work done by time, no? And only half of the energy is generated. So I will write half of work divided by time taken. Only half of the work is done. Clear? So therefore, which energy is converted into electrical energy? Ma? Gravitational potential energy. What is the formula for gravitational potential energy? Mgh. Mgh divided by time taken. Per hour, he said, no? Per hour means 3600 seconds. Now just substitute here. So half of, what is the mass of water? Mass of water is 7.2 into 10 power 4, G value is 10, and what is the height? Height is 100 divided by, clear number, 3600. So just to do this calculation, that is my required power. That's all. Very simple. Understood, number? So only half of the power is converted, no? So we are writing 1 by 2. So answer is 10 power 4 watts. 10 power 4 watts. So this is the power of this hydroelectric plant. It means per second it is generating how much energy, ma? Per second it is generating 10,000 joules of energy. Watts means joules per second only, no? So 10,000, 10 power 4 means 10,000. 10,000 joules of energy it is producing in 1 second.